Hey nerds, what's going on? It's another Pretty Boy Bat Rep, and this time we got Brawler Bash. This is the list. Very similar to my last list. I just made some minor changes, added some more feral orcs, added the magical heirloom onto my cave goblin, and a unit of wolf chariots. Trying a new intro song and some transitions here. Let me know if you like them. So, Brawler Bash was held in Durham, North Carolina, at Atomic Empire. We were really excited to go to this one. A bunch of us went down. Was Sir MC Mark, myself, our buddy Chris, Brett, and Phil Karl also rode with us on the way down. And, as fate would have it, he was my first round opponent. Let's get that music back up here for this. There he is. Look at that fashion sense. He's got, like, business on the bottom, gaming on the top. Love it. He switched out the socks for red socks later. We'll give a little Phil montage right here. This was Phil on the way to the store and then on the way home. I couldn't help myself, but, this was funny. We were joking around, you know, we're going to drive 7 hours to play each other, but we were both excited about this. He's bringing his trees, of course, and, yeah, I'll see if I can get a little revenge on him for Corner Hammer. So let's get into this. So, for those of you that are not aware, Brawler Bash is a carnage system. So it's only, you only get points for what you kill. You don't get any points for conserving units. So it's meant for a very aggressive style of play. There are no, like, traditional secondary objectives out of the rulebook. And it is a 5,000 point game, which is obviously why our lists are a little bit bigger. We do have cards that have, like, little missions on them, and we choose them each game. So my mission this game was to control more table quarters, and all that does is it gets me an extra 800 carnage points or victory points at the end. And I believe his was to kill my most expensive unit. I'm not entirely sure. But anyway, this is the board. Just straight up battle line. On the left, he's got a big unit of dryads, I believe 25 of them. He's got an eagle in the back. He has a tree father there. It's hard to tell because of the picture. Then he's got two units of thicket beasts. They are six strong, I believe, and he has his thicket shepherd BSB in one and just a regular thicket shepherd in the other so that they have bodyguard. Behind them is his tree father ancient, that's the wizard. In the middle, that giant monstrosity of a model is his general, which is an avatar of nature, not a dragon. Behind him is another eagle, another unit of 25 dryads, and then by the hill, he's got a unit of 9 Heath Riders, just as fast cav. And then on my side of the board, I've got spiders, chariots behind them, triple giants on the hill, no subtlety whatsoever, scrap wagon way behind, Pac-Man with more spiders up front. Then I've got my bunker with my mage and my BSB in it, Iron Orcs General, the Feral Orc Warlord on the Wyvern, a.k.a. the Green Dragon. And then on the right, for this game, because of the card I chose, I got a special rule that allowed me to choose a core unit or a single model to Vanguard. And I decided to Vanguard my Feral Orc Edbashers up. There's 31 of them this time, paired weapons. Full command, they have the Rending Banner. So getting very aggressive very early. There's another picture of that. And I think this is after his movement, I believe. Yes. Yes, this is his movement phase. He just moves up. You know, just trying to set some things up. He does the expected thing, which is to chaff the Feral Orcs, which is fine. I'm okay with him feeding me chaff because I have no range shooting whatsoever to take them out, so I gotta do it somehow. And, yeah, this is just him shifting stuff over. He put his wizard in a different spot, and then he decided to move her back. and nothing really of note happens. Then we go into Orcs and Goblins turn one. I conga line my spiders to double chaff the thicket beasts and the dryads and his avatar of nature. I make sure my general and BSB are in range so that they hopefully don't get terror checked. And then I move up, as you can see here. Three giants on the hill gives me rerolls for charges, which gives me great threat range. I'm hoping the chariots can just weaken up the one dryad unit on the flank. Again, I don't care if I lose them, but I need to soften them up before I can finish them off with maybe the giants. And then the Wyvern is using the building to protect his flank, but still look in and charge where necessary. Over on the right, I charge the chaff. In Magic phase, I still was too lazy and didn't make nice, pretty cards, so you'll have to bear with me. But I Raven's Winged just my Pac-Man into a little bit of a better position, got him halfway on the hill. And then I put the wheel turns up on the Tree Father, in case he gets a little frisky with him. And I boost the movement on my Iron Orcs and the Wyvern. Feral Orcs clean up the chaff. And then Trees, turn two. He charges the chaff here. So, you can see the ridiculous size of this phallic-shaped model. It kept, the tables weren't quite steady, so this kept falling over, and it would just make this thunderous crash, and like everything on the table would shake, so we replaced him with just a base. He's not dead yet, he's just sitting over there. So there's his base, I believe, yes, because he charged him into the spiders also, and then overran like 11 inches to park himself right in front of my units. Yeah, so he kills the spiders, obviously. He's moving things up aggressively on the left. No fear at all for Mr. Phil Karl. And then I pounce. So I send the chariots into the dryads. I send all three giants into his poor Tree Father. They are not backwards. They just decide to moonwalk in there because they won't fit the other way. They get in each other's way. I send my Feral Orc Warlord on a Wyvern into the flank of his Avatar of Nature, even though he has the stone skin up. I did stop Oaken Throne, but he is Resilience 8. But I am so strong with that guy, I'm confident I could still do some wounds to him. And then I march Pac-Man up to chaff the Thicket Beasts that are freed up there. The spiders don't know what to do, so they just kind of crawl over there, ready to chaff again when the Dryads kill the Chariots. And the scrap wagon is playing with itself on the hill. So this is this side of the board. The eagle was in position to chaff me again, so I had to charge it. Not much I could do about that, but at least I'm clearing chaff out. In Magic phase, I could bring the pain off on the Avatar of Nature. He actually let this go, and we both agreed later that this was a mistake on his part. We go into combat. I do a couple wounds to him. Resilience 8 is tough to get through, but a couple wounds I'm happy with. He whiffs a bit, only does one wound to me. I'm happy there. Hopefully I can finish him off on the next round. Surprisingly, in the middle, I only do two wounds to his Tree Father, and he does four wounds to me. Not at all the result I expected, but we all hold there. And the Chariots... did we do that combat yet? Let's see. Da, da, da. I don't know why I took so many pictures. This must be his movement phase. So I guess I did. The chariots went in. I killed off several dryads. I think he must have whiffed and done like one wound to me and we stick there, which is very surprising, but hey, I'll take it. I kill off the eagle. Okay, he's moving stuff around now. He charges Pac-Man. Not much happens in Magic. Everything's basically fighting now, so there's not much else to do. His Tree Father finishes off the wounded giant, which is not good. I do another two wounds to him, and he's hanging on to that final wound, even with all these Strength 6 attacks. Just ridiculous. And what ends up happening is the one giant luckily stays, but then a cowardly giant runs away. Not going as I expected. Over here, it's hard to see, but his base is still there. I don't manage to kill him. I do another couple wounds to him. He whiffs again and only does one wound to me. Two rounds of combat, I probably should be dead, or at least on three wounds. But then again, I was expecting to kill him on two rounds of combat. So we are grinding it out a bit here. Miraculously, Pac-Man does not die, but he breaks, but gets away. So still acting as chaff. Good job. And then this is my turn. So he clears the chariots off on the left. My one giant rallies, which is good. Pac-Man rallies. You can see my spiders are conga lining again to do their job and double chaff his two units over there. The feral orcs clear off the eagle and now have to face a double charge from his wizard and the dryads. Probably not going to end well for me, but what can I do? Besides, it's brawlers. I don't really care if I lose the unit. Just try to do as much damage as possible before they go down. So, I finally finish off his Avatar of Nature, which was a beautiful thing, and now I'm facing to threaten other things. Finally, the one giant that's stuck in combat beat down his tree father, so he does the same thing. Unfortunately, he's a little too close to the action, and those thicket beasts are going to get into him. So let's see. That's what the board looks like at the moment. So the thicket beasts go in, and because of the angle, they end up getting into him. He gets off stone skin on his one dryad unit, which is no bueno. He charged the dryads into the flank of the spiders, so they collapse in on this poor giant. They utterly destroy him. So the spiders actually didn't all die. They broke. There was one left, and he fled through, so he's still alive. Dryads try to overrun again, but fall just short of the other giant. Thank goodness. Pac-Man could not withstand a second beatdown. The thicket beast overrun up front here. And, yeah, this was terrible. So his dryads were resilient 7. I think I killed one. And they completely destroyed my feral orcs. God, I hate that spell. I stopped it a couple times this game, but on this occasion, he was able to push it through. So my turn. The counter charges now. This is into his BSB's unit. The Wyvern, fresh with bloodlust, charges in, and the Iron Orcs with my general charge in. I think with my magic phase, I can clean these guys up, hopefully. My giant is now acting as chaff on those dryads. Now, the funny thing is, I had positioned my scrap wagon to get a flank charge on the dryads. And the reason I wanted to do that was because I would likely be able to hold them up with the damage I'd do. And then his dryads would be chaffing up thicket beasts. Because there's really no way to kind of reform them. To get them out of the way. And it would hold up the dryads as well. Well, my scrap wagon had other plans. And said, screw you, and I rolled triples, which means it goes in a random direction, and instead of going to the dryads, it ended up going into the thicket beasts, which I was very worried about because I thought the thicket beast might kill it. There's a fair chance that would happen, so I'm a little shaky about that, but that's what ended up happening. The spider rallies on the hill. The goblins kind of shift around, just trying to stay out of the fight. In magic phase, my wizard eats a bad mushroom and hurts himself. But it was all worth it, because I could bring the pain off on the trees, and I get off deceptive glamour. So now I'm going first, I'm rerolling to hit. I think that's going to be a dead unit. Against all odds, the scrap wagon lives. Not only that, but I do two wounds to him, and I actually hold him up, which is just beautiful. Well done, scrap wagon. Unsung hero. In this combat, I do quite a number. It looks like I killed 3 or 4 thicket beasts. He doesn't do much back to me. My Wyvern Lord is trying to kill his BSB. He does. Let's see there. Something interrupted my recording. Alright, so tree in the tree's next turn. The Dryads charge my giant. So we'll see how long he can hold up there. He does get off some magic. I think he got off summer growth, so he got a thicket beast back, but I was able to stop stone skin, so a win there. And here he does a couple wins to me, I do a few wins to him. We are not going anywhere. Good job, giant. Shocking, I know, but the thicket beasts kill off the scrap wagon, but his job is already done. And then I bust through. The Wyvern Lord destroys his thicket beast, or thicket shepherd BSB. The Iron Orcs take care of the rest. The Wyvern Lord chases them down and gets those points. The Iron Orcs go into the Dryads on my turn, because they pivot, and then on my turn I get the free charge. So those Dryads should be taken care of. In Magic Phase, I could bring the pain off onto the Thicket Beasts. You can kind of see where my Wyvern Lord's positioned. I positioned him that way to face his Tree Father Ancient, who's facing him. But he'll probably end up bringing in the Thicket Beasts. So I put that on them just in case. And I also put the Wheel Turns, just trying to save my guy, if possible. In here, he almost kills my Giant, but not quite. And now he's got max attacks, 11 attacks, and yes, as you probably predicted, those Dryads are very, very dead. In his turn, though, his Thicket Beasts do charge in. He was debating with the Tree Father Ancient, but thought better of it. That was probably the smart move. So Thicket Beasts are in there. How did my Giant die? How'd that happen? I'm not sure why. Oh, I remember why. Okay. So I missed a picture here. So he goes in. I just direct my attacks onto the Thicket Shepherd he has in there. I do 3 wounds to him, but I'm not quite able to kill him. He kills me. He turns to face. So now they're in the forest. My Giant and Iron Orcs charge in. I forgot I have to take DTs because he's a Sylvan Elf. It's DTs for everybody, and the Giant kills himself. He just runs face first into a tree. But it's fine. Again, it's Brawler Bash. It's about what you kill, not what's killed on your side. So the Iron Orcs get in at least. Another good magic phase. Bring the pain, Deceptive Glamour off on them. I beat them up. He does some damage to me, but my general kills his thicket shepherd. But even so, he's stubborn in the woods. However, at this point, his general's dead, his BSB is dead. He's only leadership 8. He fails it, but I don't catch him, and I tried to pursue him. So I get half points for the unit, and that's where the game ends. So, what a great round 1 Brawler Bash game. This is what it's all about. It was bloody, but the Orcs and Goblins came out on top. It was a very close game, though, however, and really a good round for the both of us. It was only about 270-point difference. But I will take it. The debt has been repaid, so to speak, for me beating Phil Karl round 1, paying him back for his last beatdown that he handed me. So now we're square. Phil's a great guy, a lot of fun to play. But Phil, I don't want to play you again in the near future, not in tournaments at least. MVPs. For the trees, that one Tree Father took 3 giants to the face, and ended up killing one of them before it died. That was pretty impressive, so I thought. And then for me, obviously, it was the Green Dragon himself, my Feral Orc Warlord on a Wyvern. He went in, he crushed his avatar, then he went in, he killed the Thicket Shepherd BSB, helped break that unit, ran them down, and then even got 3/4 of a kill on his other thicket shepherd. So that guy was just on a rampage. And there was no stopping him. As far as what we learned today, giants versus trees is not necessarily fantastic. The strength 7 helps a lot, but because my agility is actually higher, I don't get that many attacks in the beginning. So I knew going to this game I would need multi-charges, otherwise my Giants were going to lose. It helps when they have the extra attacks. They need something generally to attack them first and beat them up a little bit. So that was a good thing to keep in mind. And even with 3 Giants into the 1 tree, it still didn't work out the way I thought it would. But it ended up working out in my favor eventually. My magic really came through for me this game. I'm liking Witchcraft more and more as I use it with this list especially. I'm a little faster to begin with, but with Witchcraft, I completely was able to outmaneuver him. And I think that's what helped, because he's a lot tougher than me. And my units are fairly fragile. So I think just being able to dictate the charges and get into the combats that I wanted really helped me in this game. But yeah, that was round 1. So thank you for watching. I hope you liked the video. Like, subscribe, do all the YouTube stuff, leave comments below. And I'll see you in the next one. Peace.